Good morning, dear students. Welcome to social science class. And today we are going to continue the same topic which we have discussed in our yesterday's live class. So we started with soil resources, which is a renewable resources, but it takes long period to form a few centimeter of soil. So soil is the uppermost layer, or it is a thin layer of the earth surface, which is the mixture of both organic and inorganic substances. Then we discussed that soil it has a profile of four layers. Okay, so it includes the topmost layer, then we have the next layer, which then again the subsoil, then we have the parent material, and the last one is the parent rock. So topsoil, subsoil, parent material, eroded weathered parent material, and last one is the parent rock. Then we have also seen that the soil formation is a slow process. It takes a long period of time to form a few centimeter of soil, and this process includes, or soil formation has been determined by five factors. So the five factors of soil formation includes climate, then relief, then it includes the parent rock, then time, and natural vegetation and other living organisms. So then we discussed that soil, and due to overutilization of soil, it is degrading day by day. Mainly soil degradation is caused by human causes and natural causes. Human causes include deforestation, mining, then overutilization of pesticides and chemical fertilizers, etc. And then natural causes are also there, like surface runoff, landslide, etc. Then we have seen that due to overutilization of land, as it is soil, it is degrading. So we must conserve the soil. So for conservation of soil, or to stop degrading the soil, there are some methods to be followed or some steps to be taken. And we discussed about two. One is mulching and another one is contour barrier. So let's see. First one is mulching, means it is the method to grow some organic matter like straw in between the plants, which is in a barren land or in a empty plot. Then we have the contour barrier. Contour means the areas of equal height. It is the line, imaginary line actually, which joins the areas of equal height. So contour barriers means over the same height areas, there are some barriers made so that soil do not get washed out by the rainwater. So contour barriers, which are made up of stones, grass, soil, etc. And there are some trenches, means like some narrow channels are being made so that water flows down, okay, in that area, and it do not wash out the entire area. Rather, the water get collected in that channel and it blows down. Then we have terrace farming. You can see in hilly areas some terrace steps like structure has been made, or it is being made. So over that terraces, crops are grown. These terraces are made so that water do not wash out the soil in the slope areas or in hill areas. Then we have intercropping. Intercropping means different crops are grown in alternate rows and sown at different times. In alternate rows, different crops are grown, but they are sown at different times to protect the soil from rain wash, so that rain cannot take away the soil, so that it remain and the roots of the plants can hold the soil. Then contour plowing. Contour barriers are the bunds, or we can say it is the some kind sort of barriers are being made by stones, then soil, etc. But contour plowing is plowing which is done over that areas of equal height, and to form a natural barrier in the hill, and it can stop blowing of the soil down the slope. Then next is shelter belt. Shelter belts are basically done in the drier regions where wind has the most important agent to remove soil. So shelter belts are made. Shelter belts means the rows of trees are planted to check the wind movement or to protect soil cover. Okay, now next is mixed farming. So mixed farming and crop rotation are also some of the methods to improve soil fertility of the soil. So these are some measures to control the soil erosion or to conserve soil. Beside that, we can also do that there should be control over excessive use of fertilizers and pesticides, and also irrigation. There should be control over that. So please note it down here. I did not mention the word control, but you have to write control over excessive use of fertilizers, because it can also cause land degradation, and also irrigation can be controlled so that it can conserve the soil. We can conserve the soil. So that is all about the soil resource, how to conserve it, and then also how soils have been formed, we have discussed. Now we are going to move on to the next resource, that is water resource. So water is a vital renewable resource, natural resource, and 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered with water. Therefore, earth is known as a water planet, because 3/4 of the area, only 1/4 of the area is land, rest 3/4 of the area is water. So ocean water is saline. Saline means content of salt. Okay, so it is the content of soil. Ocean water is saline, as we know, it contains soil and not fit for human consumption. We cannot consume, we cannot drink water, or we cannot use it for even for agriculture also. Okay, so ocean water it contains salt, or it is saline, and it is not fit for human consumption, whereas fresh water accounts only 3%, almost 3%, 2.7% of total water available. Though 3/4 of the earth is being it is water, but only 2.7% is fresh water. Rest are not fit for human consumption, and only 1% of this fresh water is available and fit for human use. It is found as groundwater, rivers, lakes, etc. So if we see ponds, etc. also, so 2.7% are fresh water. Fresh water doesn't mean that water which are hand pump we get, or this one, even the water which are found in the drains also can be fresh water. Fresh water here means which do not contain salt, okay, rain water actually, that falls over the surface and some get seeps down to the ground, and some get deposited, or it get collected in lakes, rivers, or ponds, etc. So out of the 2.7%, only 1% fresh water is available to human being, and that is found in the groundwater, rivers, lakes, etc. Because some are also found in the ice caps, which are formed in especially in the high hilly areas where ice caps, there glaciers and ice form there in found. Then fresh water is the most precious substance on earth. It can neither be added nor subtracted from the earth. It cannot be added, and it cannot, nor it can be subtracted from the earth. So we cannot add new surface, fresh water, and because there is recycle of the water, as you know already, when it falls over the surface, then again it get evaporated, then it get condensed, again it come in the form of rain or snowfall or any other form, and then again this process continues. So that is why water which is available to us is almost it is a fixed amount. So we cannot add, and nor we can subtract it. Water is used for various purposes, like it can be used for agriculture, then household also, at domestic use also, like for drinking, washing, cleaning, etc. Then water is used for agriculture, industry, generating electricity, reservoirs, dams, household use also. Please do not forget to mention domestic use also, because we use in our kitchen, we use in for drinking purpose, for cleaning, washing, etc. Then the major cause of water shortage are increasing population. So as you know that there is shortage of fresh water, though saline water is available, but that is not fit for human consumption. So the fresh water is very less in amount, and there is shortage of water for that reason. And it is because of increasing population. Then increasing demand for food and cash crops, increasing urbanization, rising standard of living of the people, water is more required now. So main reason is the increasing population, and due to increasing population, the increasing demand of water for drinking, for industries, for agriculture, for urban areas, it is increasing. Then water is available through this water cycle, which I already told you, which is a constant movement of water from ocean to atmosphere and back to ocean through precipitation. Okay, the process I already said. And then misuse and over exploitation led to scarcity of water, and judicial use by every individual is necessary. So misuse of water and over exploitation led to scarcity of water. We misuse. So that's why I request you students, do not misuse the water. When it is required, use it. Otherwise, do not misuse it, because it's fresh water is very less amount, and that much only we all human beings are using over the planet. Then government had water conservation laws and has made laws against pollution of water. Proper implementation is need of an hour, because water is available, the fresh water available is very short, and demand is increasing, and we are human beings are over utilizing it. For that reason, it is very difficult. So government has to take some steps to conserve the water resource. Then problem of water availability. Why it is there is a problem of water availability? There is water shortage in many regions of the world. It may be a consequence of variation of seasonal or annual precipitation, or the scarcity is caused by over exploitation and contamination of water. So there is a shortage of water in many areas, like in India only we can see that in the Ladakh region, no rainfall, then in Rajasthan, the water scarcity is there. So it may be a consequence, a result of variation in season, because due to seasonal and annual precipitation received amount is not same everywhere. In some parts it receives more, in some parts there is less precipitation or less rainfall is being received. That is one reason, seasonal or annual precipitation variation, one reason. Another reason is the over exploitation and contamination, pollution of or degrading the quality of the water. That is another reason. Then problem of water availability, here again the same topic. Countries located in climatic zones are most susceptible to drought and face great problem of water scarcity. Those areas which have drier climate, where rainfall is less, they have drought problem, as because there is less of less water available in that area. Then global warming and high pace of industrialization also led to raise the concern of against the clean water availability. Now due to industries, they throw the industrial waste to the land, which seeps down to the groundwater and then degrade the groundwater. Pesticides, over utilization of pesticides also. Then beside that, industrial waste are thrown to the rivers, to the water bodies directly, which are fresh water, and that's the reason it is degrading the quality or polluting the river water. And global warming is also another reason